Blue Jays taking on the Seattle Mariners. First pitch coming your way next. Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark. Ripped on a line. He dives, but can't hang on. That's a base hit. Oh, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. The pitch. That one ripped. Out of here! It's 3-0. That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it and hits it out of the ballpark. Teoscar Hernandez hits one out, and they tack one on the board. It's 4-0. Back-to-back homers, always a special feeling at the ballpark, especially if it's your team that does it, and those guys get to slap hands at home plate. This is the kind of thing that can really fire up a ball club. Two out. Pitch. And that one fouled off. Out towards left center, Kelman settles underneath it and puts the squeeze on that one. And that will end the inning. When the game comes, they make the play perfectly. You won. And there's a foul ball. Deals. And that one ripped to left, and that's a base hit. And Eugenio Suarez with a chance to make an impact with two away. Oh, now this one's blasted deep to left. Way back there, on its way and out of here. George Springer leaves the yard, and they add to the lead. It's 6-0. He came out of his shoes on that one, but managed to keep his mechanics intact long enough to get to the ball and through it, and it went a long way. Chris Flexen. Two outs, bases empty. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. now. The catch, and that'll do it. On the ground to third. Oh, nice play. On the money. Nice play. They have to be so quick with their first step reactions, hot shots like that. That's why they call it the hot corner. That's a perfect example, though. There's no way he gloves that one if he's not dialed in. Something coming his way, staying on his toes every pitch. Really nice job to get back up, set himself, and make a strong throw across the diamond. Now this one is smoked down the left field line. On its way, it's fair. Out of here. He flexes his power with that swing, and they add a run. It's 7-0. Well, he really crushed that thing down the line, and everyone had to hold their breath until it clanged off the ball. And every time that happens, it just kind of... shot or something, but really, it's just a stroke of luck that stays fair long enough.
Right center field, Bracy makes the catch, and that ends the inning. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Danny Jansen hits one out, and they tack on to their lead. It's 8-0.
He's so good at getting his arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch at that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrist to roll over, stays through the ball, gets them off, and gets the home run.
Bichette gets a chance to hit. In the air, left field, Kelvin on his way over, makes the grab on the run. And that is that. Back at T-Mobile Park, and here's the first baseman, Ty France.
There you go.
The pitch. Swing and a ball hammered left field. And out of here!
On the first pitch of an at-bat, you watch him from the on-deck circle, so when you step in the box, you're ready to pull the trigger wherever it's at. Really good job by the hitter. Total conviction on that swing.
Matt Chapman up to the plate now. That one's in there, 0-1. On the ground to third. They get one to second, tag safe. So they get one at first, but can't complete the double play. Here's Teoscar Hernandez. Swings through that one, 0-1.
Well, strike one is so critical in a bat like this with a real threat at the plate looking to do damage.
Right-handed reliever, line drive. Guys, what a play! Runner tagging for third. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. Terrific work out of the bullpen. One pitch to end the frame. George Springer takes it deep, and they tack one on the board. It's 10-3.
Well, not every home run is a majestic blast off the bat, and even though he hit it pretty well, it was anything but a sure thing to get out. But today, the conditions were right. He got just enough of it, and I think the backspin really helped that thing carry.
So up. That one is absolutely belted. That's back. And that one's gone. He sends it out of here, and they add a run. It's 11-3.
He's putting on quite the show at the dish here in this one, and he's just so locked in with this swing, and he's just not missing right now. Three homer game, and so special. And I tell you what, it's a lot of fun watching him pull it off as well.
Number 56, now. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck back there. And that one is out of here. So he leaves the yard to left, his third home run of the game.
No matter how this outing ends, that pitch is going to haunt him for a while. An 0-2 mistake. That's supposed to be a pitch out of the zone. He left it in a spot that the hitter could do some damage with, and that's exactly what he did.
Bases. Oh, and now this one's crushed. This one's on its way. And gone.
A breaking ball on the inside part of the plate requires a hitter to stay really square with his mechanics. If you fly over with the front shoulder, there's no way you keep that ball fair. An outstanding job mechanically. He deserves that home run.
So out of the pen comes...
Line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything and pulled it into the gap nicely.
In the air, center field. Puts the squeeze on it, and that'll do it. The DH, Jesse Winker. In there, and it's 0-1. Left-hand hitter waits. Just a weak fly ball this time. And an automatic double now as it hops the wall in foul ground. Hopefully on the ground. Steps on first for the out. Back to the top of the lineup. Here's the Seattle leadoff man, Julio Rodriguez. Right side. Wow, nice play. And that's a great play for the out. Into left field. It's on its way and gone. Oh, Bichette blasts one out and they add to the lead. It's 15-3.
That slider on the outside part of the plate is typically hit the other way, but to be able to get to it, pull the baseball, and get it up in the air for a home run, I'm just really impressed.
Next up for the Blue Jays. Ball out to left center. Drops into the glove, and that's the inning.
Deception in his delivery, and it's not that he's trying to deceive the hitters. He just has this natural flow that makes it hard for hitters to pick the ball up. It gets on them a little bit quicker than they anticipate, even though they know what the velocity numbers are.
And up next for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. Now fly ball to right center. And he's got it. Ball game. And the Blue Jays slug their way to a win in this one.
Sometimes I feel like the rotation's got the advantage in a wild card game. All these guys came out, no distractions. They looked ready to go from the first pitch. They got the job done, and now they're moving on.
Thank you.
Boog, this one wasn't close. Not a lot of drama at the end either. You just don't see a lot of blowouts in the postseason.
For my partner Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew at the show, I'm John Shum. You've been watching the American League Wildcard Game.